Hello everyone and welcome to our second Fun Build Rundown video. Today we'll talk about a tank Vega build for the top lane. So yeah, let's get right started. For runes, I chose Grasp just to get the enhanced auto attack and some bonus health. Then Demolish just to get towers quicker. Bone Plating, I really like this rune and many underestimated in my opinion. It just gives you some really good tankiness that's especially early on really helpful and yeah, lets you survive sometimes. And then lastly, Overgrowth, just more health, yeah, pretty self-explaining. Then Mana Flow Band, just to get the extra mana and mana regen, since we won't be building that much mana items. And lastly, Transcendence, just for the CDR, so you can spam your Q more often and get more stacks. And then for the rune stats, I chose the ability eyes, but you can go ability power 2 and another ability power and then armor. So now let's talk about why this build works so well when you build it right. Vega's passive gives him 3 ability power whenever he hits an enemy champion with an ability. And yeah, when he kills one, he gets 5 stacks. And yeah, another way to get stacks is his Q. Whenever he kills a minion or a large jungle monster, he gets a stack of his passive. So every minion he kills is 1 ability power more. And yeah, with that in mind, you can get around, yeah, when the game goes a bit more than 20 minutes, if you're good and know how to stack right, you can get around 200 free ability power just from his passive, and that's pretty much when you keep in mind that you will build almost full tank in this build. Yeah, so now for items. Since it's a tank build, I usually choose the Frostfire Gauntlet, just for the slow, since you're pretty immobile. This is really helpful to keep distance to your enemies. Other than that, to keep distance you just have your E, and if it's on cooldown you're pretty much fucked. Yeah. Another item you can build if you really want to tilt the enemy is Liandry's, but I like the Frostfire more and it fits more into the tank build. Then another item you really must buy in my opinion is Deathcap, just for the passive ability power increase. Yeah, it works really well with your passive and gives you some crazy ability power even without building any more AP items. So Frostfire and Deathcap are for me the core items. And yeah, then the situational items, I usually build Frozen Heart if I have any mana issues. It usually solves them completely for me, but if you really have big mana issues, just go for Archangel's stuff or just build a tier and see if you need it later on. However, then another item against gems with a lot of lifesteal is Thornmail, just for the anti-heal, and yeah, gives you armor and health, so yeah, basically standard tank item. Another great item for this tank build is Abyssal Mask, since it gives you the 15% damage increase when you hit your E, so yeah, it's pretty nice. And yeah, if you wanna build some more AP, I would recommend Demonic Embrace, just for the max HP burn, and yeah, gives health too, so nice tank item, or yeah, not really tank item, more bruiser-like item in my opinion, but yeah, nice item for this build overall. Exactly, for starter items I usually go Dornen's Ring and 2 health potions, yeah, really basic stuff. Exactly. So my favorite build path would be Frostfire into, yeah, depends on how far you're ahead now. But if you're really ahead, and even if you're against an AD matchup, I usually go Abyssal Mask second, then get my Death Cap, and then, yeah, usually I like Demonic, and then lastly I usually build depending on so now to my favorite build path, I usually start Frostfire into then if I'm ahead or if I'm okay, and even if I'm against an AD matchup, I usually go Abyssal Mask just for the damage increase and for the health it gives. Then third item usually for me is the Death Cap. After that, depending on the matchup, I either go Thornmail for the anti-heal, or Demonic Embrace, and yeah, I usually go Frostfire first. Then, since I'm almost all the time okay with my mana, I don't buy the Frozen Heart that often, and go if I'm ahead or if I'm okay in lane, and even if I'm against an AD matchup, I usually go Abyssal Mask just for the 15% damage increase when I hit my E. Then third item for me is almost 100% of time Death Cap. Then depending on the matchup, if I need anti-heal, I definitely go Thornmail fourth item. And then another item I usually end with is Demonic Embrace. And then for boots, I usually go Merc Treads, just to have the tenacity. But if you really lack damage in your opinion, go for the Sorcerer Shoes, it's okay too, and work great too. So yeah, I hope you like this build, and now just take a short look at the stats for a moment. You get with 200 stacks on your passive, that's something you should get if the game gets around 20 to 25 minutes. You can get 550 AP, which is pretty insane, since you only build one AP item, and yeah, with that you can really hurt the enemies. As you can see, your W deals 850 damage and your R can deal up to 1500 damage, and this will, at least the ADC, it will hurt really bad. And yeah, then you get some nice armor and magic resist and 400 health without even your grasp sex and your overgrowth. So yeah, pretty nice stats in my opinion, and yeah, you're pretty much unkillable while dealing a ton of damage. Yeah, so hope you like this build, and let's see you soon. Thank you.